नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द क्लास, प्लीज़ कम। डांस एंड एजुकेशन इज नॉट एन न्यू कंसेप्ट, नाइदर इट इज अनरिलेटेड। एंड डांस एजुकेशन एंड डेवलपमेंट थ्रू दैट इज always inherent in the traditional system, but so many things which were inherent or inside that or no one gave it a verbal form has become important to know and understand, because it has the power to create and take it further. So we would go into some of the technicalities of dance and education. You know, since last couple of decades there is tremendous development in all aspects of classical dance style of India, be its technique, method of teaching, presentation, costume, music, themes and everything. It is very difficult for a young aspirant to make a choice between the traditional and the modern. How to find the midway is everyone's struggle. To understand this process better, we look at the contemporary development in classical dance styles, namely Odissi, Kuchipudi, Kathakali, Mohiniyattam, Manipuri and Sattariya. Let's begin by looking at the Eastern style of Manipuri, Sattariya and Odissi, while the second part will look at the styles of Mohiniyattam, Kathakali and Kuchipudi. Some dance classical traditions are very strongly linked with living practices. Sattariya is one of them, recognized as a national form as recently as the year 2000. Despite the very fact that Sattariya was recognized as a major dance tradition of India, in atonement of decades of neglect of Assamese aspirations, the interventions on its body continue. In Assam, those who are well informed of the sensitivity of the Sattariya culture and are knowledgeable about the fact that Sattariya is a living tradition and presently living a double life of being both a ritual and a stage art, hesitate to transgress the maryada despite the freedom that comes from a stage art, citing its ritual sensibility. They hesitate to use Sahitya from a text other than that produced in the satras, as its very nomenclature Sattariya belongs to the satras, would result in the disapproval and fronts. Thus, when the Sattariya Kendra presented the work Chandalika based on Tagore's poetry and choreographed by Jatin Goswami, the senior most Sattariya teacher today and recipient of Padma Shri and the Sangeet Natak Academy Award, many critical voices were heard. But Chandalika project was something that was done to mark the 150th anniversary of Rabindranath Tagore, and thus is not something one sees very often. Another effort that took literature from outside the Sattariya tradition was Anita Sharma's work On the Seasons, in which she was inspired by Kalidas, Ritu Samhara, and took verses from Tagore's literature. It once again created a similar buzz in Assam, but Anita's potential and talent was recognized with the Sangeet Natak Academy Award. There is another variant of creative work that is happening with Sattariya. In an attempt to project the richness of the Indian dance forms, there has been a tendency to create a spectacle using multiple dance forms. Increasingly, is Satriya finding place in it? Guwahati-based Satriya dancer Shirodi Saikia's Chaturang comes to a mind. A similar trend, less developed though, is the use of Satriya's text and performance features being used by other dance forms. In 2013, for instance, Mumbai-based Satriya dancer Pratisha Suresh attempted that with dancers of Mohiniyattam, Odissi and Bharatanatyam, interpreting the Borgits of Shankar Deva. But as Satriya is still at the stage of discovering itself for the stage, while there is credibility aplenty of this direction, there are few contemporary works being attempted. Even in the case of Manipuri, it has been a great challenge for Manipuri dancers to tamper with the tradition. However, Manipuri choreographers like Delhi-based R.K. Singhjit Singh and his wife Charu Sheela Mathur, Chao Thabi Singh, and the young non-Manipuri choreographer from Kolkata, Preeti Patel, have extended the boundaries of Manipuri dance with contemporary sensibilities and themes. With the political life of the state ever being in turmoil, it is hard for one who represents the culture of the land to stay away from issues of violence, asymmetrical power equations and human rights. In Nupilan, Woman Struggle 2000, choreographer Charu Sija has dealt with the element of female power that surfaces to save the families from starvation and exploitation. The role of the mothers in keeping Manipuri society safe is well known. They stay awake all night, ensuring that no one makes nuisance after drinking. They fight against the menace of drug smuggling to which the young fall victim, and they keep an eye against human rights transgression in every which way they can. Thus, the woman mother is a very strong image in Manipuri culture. Preeti Patel in Malem, the Earth in 1998 interprets the myth of Earth as a mother and shows how it is used as commodity and destroyed. In another mythological story, Nahal Nok 2003, she interprets the challenges by goddess of lighting, a metaphor for female force, to those who attempt to destroy the Earth. In Agni, fire, created in 2005, Preeti Patel explores abstract concepts with an acrobatic dance tradition. Choreographer Chio Thombi deals with a vanishing species of Sangai deer found on the floating islands of Loktak Lake in a ballet titled Kaibul Lamjao in 1986. These works are a far cry from the traditional all-night dance dramas like Ras Leelas, the dances of Lord Krishna. But possibly, the credit for looking beyond and incorporating different elements from the Manipuri tradition to create a new goes to the extremely brilliant and prolific Guru Bipin Singh. Initially, his work was looked at with a certain shock value, and in hushed tones it was attributed to his chachar-based training. But today, Manipuri dance has achieved a pan-Indian position largely due to his innovative choreographies. It must also be said that great masters of yore like Guru Amubi Singh have acknowledged at various times his brilliance. He used from the many rich Tal traditions of Manipur to embellish pieces, and also the various formations that one sees in Ras dances and which even find mention in ancient texts, including the Natya Shastra like Shrinkla, like Latabandha, Bhedyaka, Gulmaka, Gulma and Pindibandha, to work artistically with groups. He broke gender barriers and made the women play the pung and built pieces around women playing the pung. In fact, in Ananga Kakshepa, he gave Radha a strong voice as he chided Kamadeva to keep his arrows in check, for she was not Parvati. Because of the path-breaking efforts of Guru Bipin Singh, today young dancers do not shy away from deviating from the tradition. They boldly attempt to bring the elements of martial arts, especially Thang Ta, which quickens the pace and invests the form with a pulsating, throbbing and vital elements of drama and energy. In case of Odissi dance, the entire dance form is a product of a creative process since it was reconstructed at Kala Vikas Kendra and other such centers in accordance mostly to rules formulated in the conclave called Jayantika. In the immense creativity that preceded the recognition of Odissi, it was Kelucharan Mahapatra who raced ahead as a result of his extremely fecund mind. This fact got acknowledged in the first Sangeet Natak Academy Award that was bestowed on him in 1966. Initially, he was hesitant to use any other style, even from the many kinetic options available in Odisha itself. But while choreographing Ekalavya, he incorporated Chau, as he felt the martial overtones in the theme warranted its inclusion. He used it again in Ardhanarishwara and then Ilyana then carried forward this initiative in her Maya Darpan. The gateways of creativity having been opened by the first generation of gurus of Odissi, today examples of creativity in Odissi abound. Sonal Mansingh created a whole range of work guided in her research by the scholar Jivan Pani. She was inspired by Odisha's Pala art to create Sunayana and Shakuntala. She used her training in Odissi and Chau to create Jara based on Sitakant Mahapatra's poem about the tribal hunter. From a popular folk tale to created Kaluri Banta, just as Madhvi created Tapoi from the maritime folklore of Odisha. One of the most important points of discord has been around the music of Odissi. So original ragas of Jayadev's Geet Govind were reintroduced by Sonal Mansingh. Hindustani music Pallavis were created by great musicians like Pandit Jasraji in the Jasraj Pallavi for Pratima Bedi. In many ways, Pallavis created for Madhavi and Arushi Mudgal by Madhup Mudgal and even by Ramahari Das, the great Odissi music composer in the recent time. Madhup Mudgal also created the music for Madhavi's path-breaking choreography Soho Mamshi that visually deconstructed the symmetry of Odissi and presented it in an off-center view. Even when it came to the percussion, the inclusion of the Dakhani Mridanga in the oral scape of the percussion created a conflict between the Guru Kelucharan Mahapatra as he felt his Kolkata-based student Sharmishtha Bishwas, as the Guru felt that it was not within the vidhi of Odissi. But again, most of Odissi was a creative effort, albeit sanctified by the Jayantika process. Sharmila Bishwas, a disciple of Guru Kelucharan Mahapatra, is a seasoned Odissi dancer with a well-trained group of dancers. A recipient of the Sangeet Natak Academy Award for 2011 for her contribution to Odissi, she's studies of traditions of Odisha are replete with deep research. Devi Bharani, in praise of goddess Sambaleshwari, is based on ritual and music of Western Odisha. Every year during the festival of Dashera, the goddess's spirit is evoked with ritual music called Devi Bharani, which evokes a trance-like mood. Sharmila's solo interpretation of Shurpanakha's character also bears her signature. Her depiction is different from the usual narrative of nasal disfigurement by Lakshmana. Instead, she is chosen to impersonate her as a royal princess and a woman in love with Prince Ram. Her group composition Gati Vilas is inspired by Sanskrit verse commonly chanted by the rural Mridanga players of Odisha. Described attributes of ideal performer comparing her gaits, stances and energies, expressions with those of different animals. Thus, what is evidence is that the parameters set by Jayantika are being rolled back. The Devaprasad dance gharana had gurus like Gangadhar Pradhan, Durga Charan Ranbir and Gajendra Pradhan. Much of the significant work there after of this bani comes filtered by the late Guru Gangadhar Pradhan. It is being carried forward by Aruna Mohanty and a host of male gurus like Bachitrandra Swain, Lingraj Swain and Manoranjan Pradhan in Odisha and Rimli Ibrahim in Malaysia. Bachitrandra Swain's Tal, Madhurya, Zesty and Peppy set on the bodies of five male dancers is an example of how to intrinsic tandavness in Devaprasad Das's style is being explored. Rimli Ibrahim envisions creativity as total experience, easily transcending national boundaries. With more than 40 original dance compositions in his repertoire in both traditional and contemporary idioms, he is globally celebrated dancers. He draws inspirations from many influences. From the intense Guru-Sishya relationship that Gajendra Kumar Panda had with Guru Devaprasad Das, he created adorations. Rimli rejects compartmentalization. He believes that in classical, the folk and tribal must also come. His productions Ras Unmasked has intertwined traditions with contemporary sensibilities. In his renowned Dash Mahavidyas, Rimli uses music from East and the West. In some Pallavis, he has used Odissi traditional music but has deconstructed it for resonant layering. One of our Gangadhar Pradhan's youngest disciple was Bijayani Satpati, Bismillah Khan Yuva Puraskar awardee, who has created a unique position for herself at Nityagram, where she has worked consistently in creating a powerful kinetic and several new choreographies that have impressed locally, nationally and especially the world. One of the most significant of Gangadhar Pradhan's disciples has been Aruna Mohanty, who went on to inherit a part of the cultural equality that was created by her guru. She has a demanding performance schedule and has yet found time to teach, choreograph and organize festivals. With the well-trained male and female dancers of the Odissi Academy, she has aesthetic work on exploring rasa through Ramayana. Popular Odissian myths and songs related to Lord Jagannath are also some of the subjects that have fired her creativity. Some of her choreographies are employing lesser-known traditions of Odisha and use dialogues and commentary in English to become more accessible to national and international audiences. Independently, in Delhi, which is fast becoming a significant center for the growth of Odissi, dancers like Kiran Sehgal and Ranjana Gohar, disciples of Mayadhar Raut, Kavita Behra Dwibedi, daughter and disciple of Guru Hare Krishna Bechra and Shagun Bhutani, are producing significant work. As most run dance schools, they are doing important group work. Kiran has created Talangika and also worked on incorporating Chau and Odissi apart from poetry in Hindi, whereby recent efforts have been based on poetry about Hindi as the Rashtrabhasha, based on the poem of Rudul Garg. Kavita Dwivedi has worked on unusual themes like the idea of moksha among the women from the Buddha story. Called Shweta Mukti, it celebrates a feminine glory of Nirvana,
The poetry for this was from a variety of sources and a variety of languages, and included some freshly written poetry by literature and scholar Kedar Mishra, with music by iconic Ramahari Das. In Odisha today, the scholars and literatures are helping in putting new work. Apart from Kedar Mohapatra, the role of Nityananda Mishra is also noteworthy in their direction. Shagun's work often uses another style, especially Chau. For instance, in her choreography, Oppositions, she used Saraikela Chau and Odissi to explore the sheer joy of abstract movement. In Mohiniyattam, the contribution of the mother-daughter team of Bharati, Shivaji and Vijayalakshmi is noteworthy. Vijayalakshmi's most recent and outstanding choreographic work has been Swan Lake, based on the celebrated composition of the great Russian composer Tchaikovsky. This choreography has not only added a unique dimension to the repertoire of Mohiniyattam, but has been one of the first attempts of its kind in the genre of classical Indian dance as well. Some of her recent productions have been Unniracha Parayapati and Bhanu Singer Padavali. Music has been one of the pillars holding up her work. She has also worked on costumes, and so for Unnircha, she not only used a vocabulary inspired by Kalaripayattu, but converted the regular skirt costume into a dhoti type of costume to effect those movements in. Parayapti was her tribute to the marginalized women of Bengal, and she created a moving and oral landscape by using various Bengali folk instruments, charches, dhag and dhol, with mandalam, edakka and mridangam. Bhanu Singer Padavali was her tribute to Tagore on the eve of his 150th birthday. In Prajapati, she made use of the traditional style of wearing sari of Bengali women on top of her Mohiniyattam costume. In Bhanu Singer Padavali, her Krishna wore an innovating costume designed by Moma Ganguly that has been inspired from Kathakali. In 2013, Vijayalakshmi created a new choreographic work titled Rain, using Tagore's poetry that follows a slow pace ideally suited to Mohiniyattam's kinetics. When it comes to Kuchipudi, there is not much startlingly modern work happening, just more of the same, unless you count Shantala. Shantala Shivalingappa is a young Kuchipudi dancer brought up in Paris, the daughter of Bharatanatyam dancer and teacher Savitra Nair, and trained by Vempati Chinna Satyam. Her traditional work is marked by musicality, the power and precision of her footwork, and the absolute clarity of her movements. In Swayambhu, for instance, she sings herself as well, and to the grace of her upper body and jump that seems to come out from nowhere, light and airy. She has also worked with Pina Bausch's dance theatre Wartel, which she joined in 1908. Her mother exposed her to contemporary theatre and dance at a young age, and she has explored it more and more over the years. Working with Sidi Larbi Charkoi, Peter Brook and Ushio Amagatsu, among others, Shivalingappa performed in Bausch's Nephis and Bamboo Blues and Odido, and for a few years she also danced in Cirque du Prem. She has also performed evenings of contemporary solos created for her by Bausch, Oshino Amagatsu, her mother and herself. Regrettably, in India, Shantala is dismissed as being a Western dancer for her international work. When it comes to Kathakali, most would agree that Kathakali is not a dance form. It is also not a dance drama, but a theatre form in which we use dance effectively. Dance is used to express emotions each time, but in the modern impulse of Indian dance,
Kathakali has played a stellar role. Some of Udaishankar's famous works include movements patently inspired by Kathakali. But today, some of the more interesting contemporary work in Kathakali is happening internationally. Peters Brooks used Kathakali as one of the art forms in his multicultural theater production of Mahabharata. France-based dancer and choreographer Annette Lidée belongs to a generation of foreign dancers who trained deeply at Kalamandalam almost 40 years ago when she trained in Bharatanatyam as well as Kathakali. Today, Annette Lidée is a senior director and choreographer who specializes in intercultural contemporary creation with a focus on the dance and contemporary creations, theatre traditions of India and France. She then spent several years in rural Kerala practicing and performing Kathakali with Sadananam and Kalamandalam institution. She initiated and participated in the translation of 7 Indian contemporary plays into French for India Scene Project. Her Keli Dance Company produced the original King Lear in Kathakali and transformed and translated and adopted the Shakespearean play for Kathakali in 1989. It has toured the world till 1999, about 10 years. Later in 91, she created La Sensitivity based on Shelley's poems, The Sensitive Plant. She used the Kerala ritual of Kolam Izhuttu, or the destruction of Kolam, as a metaphor in it. In 1994 and 1995, she created Trans Malabar using Thayam in addition to Kathakali. Thayam was well suited as the work was against gender abuse, and Thayam is the stylized return of the goddess. Her recent work also includes Mithun that she premiered in India during the Ignite Festival of 2015 and featured French dancers and Indian Kathakali dancers. Annette saw Mithun as the conjunction of diversities and either fertility seeding. Thus, work pushing the boundaries of the established forms is happening at all times and in many ways, sometimes with themes and at other times with the presentation. All in all, it goes on to prove that the tradition is not a fixed and is constantly reinventing itself and taking on new challenges. Thank you. Bye-bye.